you, everyone coming in. Welcome to, what is it, the fourth edition of Surface Interval. Hi, Rosalie. She's a genius. She's in everything. Thank you. Yeah, we're going to wait until like it just went live and normally.
Rosie.
I don't know how to do this.
I don't know how to pronounce it. Sorry.
But are you guys looking from Facebook or from StreamYard?
No, from the app, from StreamYard.
Got it.
No. It gets really confusing if not.
Got it.
See, you have to see the streamlined, and then if you watch the Facebook, it's a little bit on delay. So you're.
Yeah, of course.
Bueno, welcome everyone. And
hi.
This is Giovanni Bianco, finally.
Canada.
Hi, everybody. Nice to meet you all. Thank you, Lucre. Thank you, Kanda, for sharing this time with me.
Thank you for joining us. So, as Kanda just said, this is Giovanni Bianco, our good friend. And as we mentioned of the post, the person that has taught us pretty much everything what we know about equalization. So the ones that have been in the water with us, if you thought that we knew a little bit about it, like, this is our, as I like to joke about it, but this is our equalization master. Yeah.
Big words, right? Don't sound embarrassing.
No pressure.
No pressure.
So Joa comes, like, he works and with Moving Limits. He'll be explaining you a little bit more about what Moving Limits is and their platform. And with Amankai, we've been forming ourselves to participate out of the shared platform to become equalization instructors as well. So we are creating a really nice bond and project together. So we are excited to introduce him. He's also part of our Amankai network. Yeah, for the ones that have been seeing us and have been hearing us, the Amankai network is a net of instructors around the world that are managing, like, that are each one on their locations, but we all share kind of the same school or the same philosophies. And the idea is that you can go to any part of the world and join one of us and keep exploring the world. So Joa is the person that you will find in Italy at the deepest pool of the world. So I highly recommend you going and visit him whenever we can travel again.
Yeah, that's what I want to say. Yeah, whatever it will be possible again to come in Y40.
Exactly. And you can share it, like, if you want to share it in Spanish.
Sí, really bueno.
Quick.
Buenas tardes a todos. Vamos a tratar de estar haciendo el vivo con la mejor traducción que podamos. Y al mismo tiempo, this requires a lot of brain. Este Giovanni Bianco es uno de nuestros maestros de ecualización y uno de los instructores del network que hoy está conformando Amankai. Amankai está trabajando en tener varios instructores alrededor del mundo que compartan el de qué lugar enseñamos. Y bueno, Giovanni es uno de ellos, ha estado con nosotros desde pretty much desde que Lucre y yo también empezamos a ser instructores. Jova ha estado a lo largo de todo ese camino y nos ha visto progresar y crecer. Entonces, hoy forma parte de todo este lindo grupo de personas que puede y quiere enseñar alrededor del mundo junto a nosotros. Y además trabaja en profundidad en toda la parte de ecualización y demás, en la Y40, en la Y40. Una de las piscinas más, no, perdón, la piscina más profunda del mundo que está en Italia. Si varios han escuchado de una piscina profunda, esa es. ¿Sí? Vamos a empezar, vamos a estar tratando de hacer estas traducciones lo más cuerdas posibles, básicamente.
Y ahora so there you go, Joa. It's all yours.
All me? So, hi everybody. I'm Giovanni Bianco. They basically said everything about me, but I would just like to spend a little bit, some few words more. I'm a programming instructor since 5 years, 6 years. This is the 6th year that I work like instructor, freediving instructor. Basically, I specialized in our school, Moving Limits. It specialized on equalization, and I'm a spearfisher as well, so I'm a pretty boring guy. When I don't talk about freediving, I talk about spearfishing. So yeah, you know. during now this chat that we're gonna have, we will see a bit what is Moving Limits, what we did for equalization, and we'll try to reply also a little bit of which are the main barrier on equalization that can happen during a dive. Lucre, do you let's say, do we want to start directly with this topic, or you want to to translate? I don't know how to deal with the
topic. Can translate first with your introduction
Pretty much what we said before, really. I think that now it's important to call on people to know, because many people that may not know us, Amanca, either on the group who is following, is that we are focused a lot in the equalization. So that's why we want to bring you what the most out of it today. There is going to be a lot of questions, but we are going to do all of that at the very end. See, so we're just going to open here a little book, and then all of the questions and stuff will be done at the very end. See, or in detail, whenever. Chicos, todo lo que sean preguntas y demás, podemos hacerlas. Vamos a estar ahora empezando a hablar un poco. También Amancay es una escuela que nos estamos enfocando en ecualización mucho y es un topic para todos que puede ser súper interesante. De igual forma, todo lo que sean preguntas y demás, las vamos a preguntar un poquito más al final. Déjenlas escritas, déjenlas asentadas y nosotros les vamos a ir respondiendo acorde también a lo que evolucione la conversación, ¿vale?
So, yeah, what we were saying is like, Joe, I was bringing the first thing that we want to bring, and I think one of the main concerns of people when we're finding trouble of equalizations. I was talking with Joe and we were like, okay, how can we generalize equalization? Because on one hand, it's really personal, you know, like it's your dive, it's your personal barrier that is causing it. But at the same time, the good part is that equalization is a technique, and is a technique that it can be worked on. Sometimes it will take a little bit more of patience, but it is a technique that can be worked on. And that's the first thing I think we want to bring to you today, introducing you, Joa, to this and introducing equalization to the surface interval. It is a topic that we will go repeating through the months. And actually we have workshops planned and things like that to help you achieve. Equalization does require a lot of try workout compared to our imagination that is like, oh, we need always to be in the water to work our equalization. No, we actually need land for it, yeah? So this is why we wanted to bring up this topic. And on our chat, we were seeing, okay, how can we try to put this on general terms, you know? We probably have people right now watching that are beginners, maybe, that doesn't have really that kind of barriers, or actually, and found their barriers further down in depth, or others that actually are just starting and it's common to have kind of a rusty way into freediving through equalization. So we wanted to bring this up to show you that is one is the most common barrier that freediving can have. And so if you are a person that is struggling through equalization, you're not alone. Like, it's a lot of people. And one thing that like just came up to my mind that is something that Moving Limits talks and would share as well philosophy is that he'll talk more about that, but that concept of that we all should be able to freedive, that equalization shouldn't be what stops us of enjoying freediving, of enjoying the water. So I'm super, like, we were looking at how to bring this, and we thought that a good way to bring it to you guys is starting by covering what are the general barriers that get presented in equalization through your journey. It's not the same barrier, the one you're going to have on the first few meters, than the one that you're going to find as you start going deeper into your dives, you know? Can I, ¿vos querés traducir eso before we? Okay, I can introduce that. Lo que estaba mencionando es que, bueno, lo que queremos entrar con yoga, habíamos estado hablando de cómo traer el tema de ecualización. La ecualización, para los que saben, es una de las barreras más grandes que la apnea tiene, pero al mismo tiempo es una técnica, y es una técnica que con paciencia y con el entrenamiento correcto se logra. Se logra y tenemos muchísima gente que puede dar fe en eso. Y Giovanni se dedica a eso. El entrenamiento de la ecualización no es necesariamente en agua. Realmente primero la tenemos que lograr manejar fuera del agua para luego poder aplicarla en nuestros buceos. Y esto es lo que Giovanni en Mewen Limits se dedica a, ¿no? Entonces, hablando en cómo traer este tema para todos, lo que quisimos traer primero es las barreras generales que tiene el apnea a las diferentes profundidades. No es lo mismo la barrera que va a tener alguien en los primeros metros, lo cual es muy común, y lo primero que queremos traerles es eso. Si eres un apneísta principiante que se ha encontrado con esta barrera en los primeros metros de profundidad, es normal. No estás solo, desafortunadamente, es la barrera más grande que hay en el apnea. Y algo que me encanta compartir, que Jova me lo ha traído por medio de Moving Limits también, es que ellos, su filosofía es decir que el mundo no tendría que estar limitado a hacer apnea por la ecualización. O sea, que cualquier otra razón por la cual tú no quieras estar en el agua está bien, pero que no sea la ecualización la que nos frena, porque realmente es una técnica que se puede trabajar y con paciencia y dedicación y el entrenamiento en manos de gente que realmente sabe cómo transmitirlo, se puede llegar a eso. Entonces, lo que queremos empezar a cubrirles ahora es las barreras que presenta la apnea desde tus primeros comienzos, las barreras generales que vemos como instructores, desde el principio de tu carrera como apneísta en la introducción hacia la profundidad, porque no quiere decir que a los 20 o a los 30 o a los 40 se te presenten barreras también de ecualización, ¿sí? Así que, yeah, Joe, it's all yours if you want to introduce the topic and start talking a little bit of the barriers we find.
Yeah, yeah, thank you for this introduction. Lucre said, most of the time, I would say like not 100% of cases, but kind of like 98% of the cases, the barrier that we find in equalization is not due to physical problem, but it's more about a technical problem. I learned this. This is the first lessons that I get from equalization, and it's also why I fall in love with equalization. I remember that I was just the beginning of my freediving instructor career, and like in the old movie, my girlfriend of the time, she was not able to equalize. That's why I started to study a little bit why she was not able to equalize. And this is really, really curious, because what happened that she started doing freediving and she could equalize. Like all the summer that she tried to equalize, she was really able to equalize. She reached also important depth, like 30 meters, even something more. After came winter in Italy, so we couldn't go diving anymore. And in the next summer, she was stuck. Like she couldn't equalize neither 5 meters. And we went to doctor, we went everywhere, we tried everything, and she was not able to equalize. And I was thinking, but why this is happening? Why this is happening? This should be something that has changed. And I was just looking at her equalizing, and I was thinking what I was doing while I was equalizing. And I'm a hands-free. I mean, I'm born hands-free. Like I can equalize hands-free. So I'm pretty lucky in that. Okay, I have to admit. But I mean, I was able to do Frenzel and a kind of equalization technique. So I was just looking what I was doing, and what she were doing, and I start to see that there were kind of differences in movement, in technical movement that she were performing. So I started studying a little bit with books, with Federico Mana books. Federico Mana is the founder of Moving Limits. We are partnered together. Now we are partner. But at that time, I mean, I was still looking, I mean, seemed like the god of equalization, let's say. And thanks to that study, I start to see that equalization was something about technical. So I went a little bit more deep in that matter, and I figure out that when you get equalization problem in the first, let's say, 10 meters, yeah, we can say 10 meters, that most of the time is about the equalization technique that you are using. Let's say that we have three kind of equalization technique when we talk about.
Perdón, I'm going
to cut. You're right. Stop.
Claro, exactly.
You're right.
Oh, wait.
I have to translate all of this.
No. I was just very.
I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. Entonces, lo que está diciendo Joao un poco está contando cómo empezó con todo este tema de la actualización, que de hecho, it was a question that I wanted to ask, era una pregunta que. Quería hacerle de cómo empezó todo este interés por la ecualización, que su novia del momento no podía ecualizar en su época. Y lo que hizo fue empezar a trabajar con ella, técnicas de ecualización, mucha observación en lo que ella estaba haciendo, que primero pudo ecualizar bien, luego dejó de ecualizar un año y se bloqueó. Y cómo él empezó a averiguar, ya siendo instructor de apnea, empezó a averiguar y observar muchísimo lo que ella estaba haciendo y lo que él estaba haciendo y a empezar a encontrar diferencias entre las técnicas que estaban usando. Y a partir de ahí, bueno, lo trabajaron. And I think now she can equalize, ¿no?
Yeah, now she can equalize and she goes really deep, actually. Yeah, and she goes really deep.
Y de hecho, sí, es una gran apneísta y now because observation and working on herself as well, she's doing really, really good with depth, with equalization, with teaching, with everything. Entonces, un montón de lo que trae también aprender en la apnea es la propia observación y todo, que hoy esta persona está yendo, uff, sí, está cabrona, así que nada, la queremos mucho. No, perdón, yo. Continúo, entonces va a empezar a explicar un poco los tres primeros pasos de los pasos que puedes encontrar, los bloqueos que puedes encontrar a lo largo de la apnea. Yes, continue.
Can I keep going? Okay, thank you.
You need to let him know.
No, I mean, I understand what she says, but I didn't know if she just finished.
I think I did. No, I said no.
So, we were saying that the first barrier that the people can meet is in the first, let's say, 10 meters. And that is because of technical problem. We have three, let's say, kind of equalization technique that they are called Valsalva, Frenzel, Head Hands Free. And Valsalva is that kind of technique that for free diving doesn't work at all, we can say. Instead, with scuba diving, I don't know if there are some scuba divers, even that kind of equalization technique works. It can work. So this is the first limit that somebody can get. It's just the wrong equalization technique. Equalization is a kind of instinctive maneuver. What does it mean? It means that everybody know how to equalize because it's just a kind of instinct. If you think all the time that somebody talk to you about equalization or try to talk to you about equalization, it just said maybe pinch your nose and push and that's it. And if you also try now just pinching your nose and pushing or blowing, you will see that your ear will pop. That is because it's an instinct maneuver.
Chicos, la primer traba puede ser la pura técnica. Si nos ponemos a pensar, la ecualización es un movimiento instintivo. Instintivo, donde uno se pincha la nariz y va a reaccionar de alguna forma en cuanto una persona te dice apriétate la nariz y ecualiza, si bien no sabemos ni siquiera qué es, algo va a salir para que intentemos. Entonces, invitamos a todos a pincharse la nariz e intentar ver qué es lo que están haciendo ahora.
Comentaba que hay tres tipos principales de ecualización. Es Valsalva, Frenzel y handsfree, manos libres. ¿Sí? Entonces, bueno, lo que contaba es la primera barrera, Valsalva, es algo que puede funcionar capaz hacia alguno que hace buceo acá, si hacen scuba, o si lo hacen acá mismo les va a funcionar, pero no necesariamente, desafortunadamente, no funciona en apnea, lo cual es generalmente la primera barrera, como explicaba Cande, es la primera falla técnica que nos puede estar limitando la profundidad. Yeah, you can go ahead.
Okay, and because it is an instinct maneuver, can happen that people just because of this instinct perform Valsalva or perform Frenzel, or if they're really lucky, they can also perform handsfree. So no need to pinch their nose to equalize. Nobody, I mean, it's just about instinct. And usually there is a kind of majority of equalization technique. We can say like the most part of free diver, if we just take a group, for example, of 10 free divers, maybe 8 of them, they just will do, this is just number, it's just an example, doesn't have any like, I mean, it's meaning, not really yeah. real, yeah, meaning, it's just an example. 8 people, if they pinch their nose, they just do Frenzel, so they can equalize and they don't find that barrier in the first 10 meters. Let's say 2 would find that barrier, so they will just get stuck on equalization. But that doesn't mean that they can't learn how to equalize, that they can't learn how to perform Frenzel. Frenzel and how Valsalva works. Do you want to go a little bit into that?
We can do like just a little okay. bit of me to, so that they can know the difference between one or the other one. We can kind of explain okay. minimal what it is.
Before that, okay. lo que está explicando, bueno, entonces instintivamente podemos pincharnos la nariz y hacer tanto ya sea Frenzel como Valsalva. Generalmente en un promedio por ahí, quizás 8 de cada 10 son generalmente Frenzel, which I'm surprised with that.
That doesn't happen to my
I'm surprised with the high number, pero que 8 de 10 generalmente al pincharse ya hacen Frenzel naturalmente, ¿sí? Que no es algo que no se puede aprender, la técnica, y esto lo adhiero yo. Muchas veces lo que pasa es que, no me olvidé, perdón. It's really hard to do translation, ¿eh? When you speak Spanglish and you don't know the terms in Spanish. Pero básicamente que si uno se pincha va a poder reconocer Valsalva o Frenzel, que no quiere decir que no vayas a poder aprender la técnica. ¿Y qué más dijo Lu?
Eso, iba a entrar a explicar un poquitito cuál es la técnica
just,
Valsalva.
Yeah, just a little thing to recognize what Valsalva is. If maybe there is people that perform Valsalva, at least they know what Valsalva mm-hmm. is. Valsalva is a kind of equalization technique. It's a pressure equalization technique. What does it mean? That when you pinch your nose, that you can send the ear inside your middle ear, so you can just feel your suction tubes and your ear popping basically, just because you are blowing directly air out from your lungs. What does it mean? It means that you are blowing. Like if you're just blowing from your nose, you pinch your nose and the pressure in your throat, in your mouth, in your nasal cavity increase. That increase of pressure open the entrance of your ear. The entrance of your ear is called the suction tubes. So the air goes inside and you feel the equalization. To understand if you're doing that kind of equalization technique, most of the time you can just be focused on your belly. If you feel that your belly is pushing, is moving, you feel like abdominal contraction, that means that you're doing Valsalva.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Yeah, I think that if you
want to not even translating it. Entonces, lo que está diciendo yo un poco es que la pura, o sea, cuando hacemos Valsalva, estamos soplando, ¿sí? A los oídos, en teoría. Lo que se pasa es lo que hacemos es tensamos los músculos y todo en los pulmones para empujar aire hacia arriba. Entonces, si ustedes se pinchan y sienten que de alguna manera están tensando todo lo que son los abdominales y esa área, ¿sí? Vamos a estar haciendo Valsalva. Entonces, enfóquense en pincharse la nariz, tocarse el diafragma o la panza y observar qué movimiento están haciendo. De igual manera, en el Valsalva, sí les van a ecualizar los oídos, sí van a sentir el pop que estaban hablando antes los chicos. Entonces, observen eso. Y ahora el Frenzel.
Yeah, and the horror Frenzel. You said that the other equalization technique, it's Frenzel. Frenzel, to send the air inside your ear, you don't use directly your lungs, so you don't blow air from your lungs, but you just push air from your mouth. So basically, this is the first difference, between these two equalization techniques. In Valsalva, the air comes directly from your lungs, so your glottis is open. The glottis is the door that separates your lungs from your mouth. Instead, in Frenzel, you add air inside your mouth, your glottis is closed, and you push the air up. To push the air up, most of the time you use just your tongue or your throat muscles, your larynx to push. It's like pushing air up with your tongue like piston, and that air goes inside your eustachian tubes.
Bien.
Makes sense?
Entonces, y el Frenzel de otra forma es la compresión de aire, pero de la boca. Entonces, en vez de estar empujando de los pulmones al oído medio, estamos cerrando la glotis, que en el caso del Valsalva tenemos la glotis abierta. Cerramos la glotis y utilizamos la lengua o los larynx, como los músculos, para empujar aire de la boca al oído medio, ¿sí? O comprimir el aire de la boca al oído medio.
Okay, I just show you.
This is an exam for us as well. I know.
Yeah, of course. I just show you the difference between Valsalva and Frenzel. So if you just look at me, I'm gonna do some Valsalva technique, and you will see that also my chest will involve it because I need to create a lot of pressure to equalize it.
Va a estar haciendo Valsalva a diferencia de Frenzel.
I'm pushing too much. This is Valsalva. It's in Frenzel because I'm pushing with my tongue. You can just see my Adam's apple moving up and down. For example, this is Frenzel. And this is the technique that can solve the first barrier of the equalization. So for all the people who get stuck in the first meter, this is why. That's why. Because they are just performing Valsalva instead of performing Frenzel.
I think this is a very good tip that Jova is giving for the people that are not that familiar yet. Yesterday, I gave a chat on ocean stories, and some of you may be here. Like, they were talking to me about problems of equalization, even in scuba diving. And this is the main thing that you may want to start looking at. That one of the most important parts that this brings also is the relaxation. If you observe like the Frenzel equalization, there's no tension, it's relaxed, it's soft. While in the moment that you're trying to push the air, the moment that you're tensing yourself to get it, automatically you're going into a Valsalva. So I think that something to bring with these two techniques as a tip for everyone is look at your relaxation when you're trying to perform the equalization. That will also help you realize a little bit if you are tensing up and crunching everything, or if you're soft, that your air can flow into
as well, very quickly before, because now we might have people doing in front of the mirror. Sometimes you might be doing that tension and as well moving the no Adam's apple that women have, but the tongue, basically.
The throat, yeah, we can say the throat.
Yeah, the throat. Thank you. Observe whether if you're doing both at the same time, because that means that one is not really necessary, which would be Valsalva, and slowly you can already start focusing on your head. Like, imagine you cut your head and you're just trying to work on that. Lo que decíamos, chicos, un poco era que Jova estaba mostrando las diferentes formas y además traerles de mi parte que chequen un poco si por ahí también están haciendo tensión y moviendo también la lengua o la garganta en este sentido, que puede ser un error también, ¿no? Que pensemos que estamos haciendo uno, pero estamos haciendo una combinación. Y Lu.
Yo traía un poco lo que es la relajación. Para la gente que estuvo viéndome ayer en Ocean Stories, y hay muchos scuba divers que también pueden tener problemas de ecualización, y esto es la primera barrera que pueden observar. A veces con Valsalva nos damos cuenta que hay mucha tensión, mucho esfuerzo. Entonces, y si como dice Cande, podemos estar haciendo los dos con ese esfuerzo, tratar de focalizarnos que Frenzel no necesita ese esfuerzo. Entonces, si nos focalizamos en estar relajados y estábamos combinando, muy probablemente podamos aislar y focalizarnos en la parte de la boca y en mover la lengua como pistón y no en la fuerza de la ecualización. Sí. ¿Sí? Cuanto sí. Más, una cosa, like, more deep we go, the less effort we need. So if you're going down and you feel that you're tensing each time more for your equalization, and I'm talking about the first few meters, try to relax your body and observe what happens.
Sorry guys that we're taking so long in translating, but this is a very important topic and very interesting topic for everyone, so it might take a little bit longer. Continue.
I'm in quarantine, no hurry.
I might join you with the beer, actually.
Yeah, I can stay with you, don't worry.
We can convert this into an aperitivo in any minute.
I'm gonna start.
Not going to the water or anything.
Yeah, it's 5 o'clock somewhere and it's past midday, so I can start drinking.
Cool, that's cool. The other is an Frenzel technique. The limit, the barrier of Frenzel technique, is just, I mean, that's not the limit. I would like to turn it another way. We said that Valsalva doesn't work. Frenzel, or it can work within the first 10 meters. Frenzel is a kind of technique that works, so that allow you to equalize till you have air inside your mouth. So when you don't have air anymore inside your mouth, or when you are not able anymore to have air or to take air inside your mouth, that's the point where either Frenzel is stopped working. This is very important because it will introduce us the second barrier on equalization of the second kind of depth. I don't know if you want to say this.
Entonces, lo que está explicando un poco es que el Frenzel, por la pura técnica de Frenzel, nos va a servir hasta que tengamos aire, hasta que nos hayamos acabado básicamente el aire en la boca. Si nosotros no tenemos más aire en la boca, entonces ya saltamos al segundo paso, que would be a little bit, probably a little bit deeper, pero not necessarily, because it can. ¿Por qué I switched?
Sí.
This is my brain. No, entonces, bueno, eso, lo del Frenzel que vamos a tener.
Que nos introduce la siguiente barrera.
Hasta que tengamos aire en la boca, y una vez que ya no tenemos aire en la boca, entonces vamos a saltar al próximo paso, ya una vez que diferenciamos el Valsalva del Frenzel. Continue, sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, my brain
The third and the last equalization technique is hands-free. Hands-free is the kind of technique that allows the diver to equalize without putting the without pinching the nose. Why? Because that diver has the control of the opening of the stiation tubes. So if he can open the stiation tubes, he doesn't need to create a lot of pressure, but he can just with a really small pressure can send air inside his eardrum, inside your middle ear. And usually it makes that is possible because of the mask, even if it's possible to perform entry even without the mask.
So, Jova, sorry, this is a technical question. In hands-free, basically, mm-hmm. We are actually equalizing and restoring volume, not enough.
What do you mean?
In the ear. So you do hands-free. Mm-hmm. You click the state agents and you feel it, but you don't feel like proper equalization, right? You're not pushing actually full on air to the Middle East.
Well, it depends. It depends. If I talk with many hands-free divers, they're going to say me what you are saying. But if I feel my hands-free, I would say that I feel pretty sane, like Frenzel. It's not that, that big volume inside my ear, but it's really, really close to that.
Okay. Vale, entonces hands-free, chicos, como muchos apneístas sabrán, o muchos no, es la técnica de no pincharse la nariz a la hora de ecualizar, y esto es porque uno tiene el control de los tubos de Eustaquio para poder balancear la presión del oído medio y no necesitar pincharse la nariz para hacerlo.
Claro. Abrirlos voluntariamente, solo para que...
Eso, abrirlos voluntariamente. Entonces, nada, hay mucha gente que es afortunada en eso, hay mucha que no y lo quiere aprender. Y Giovanni,
como Giovanni,
actually,
Giovanni Candelaria.
Giovanni
y Candelaria.
which actually, see, I am hands-free too, but it takes me to tell you that people, I see people just driving crazy to learn hands-free. Nah. Make sure you learn Frenzel yet, because at some point, at some stage in your diving, you're probably going to need the Frenzel awareness, let's say. You can correct me if I'm wrong, Joanne.
No, you're right, but actually hands-free is a Frenzel technique. It's exactly like Frenzel. The only difference is that you have the control of your tubes, so you can open it, and the pressure that you need to create with your tongue or with your mouth anyway, it's really, really small. It's really, really small. Really, really low pressure. But actually, it's a kind of Frenzel.
Okay.
I would like to expand. These are the three, like, let's say, equalization technique. But I would like to spend a few words, maybe because there are beginners or either like advanced free diver, but then about the meaning of equalization. Because most of the time, I saw that the concept of equalization is misunderstood. It's not really clear. Every time that I ask somebody, some students, but either, yeah, students, what equalization means, I got the reply that equalizing means restoring the pressure, the outside pressure. It's like
balancing the pressures.
Yeah, balancing the pressure. It's like if in our imaginary is the pressure of the sea that is pushing inside our eardrum, and from inside we need to push the pressure back. We need to push the sea back. But actually, it's really wrong concept. Bye, Kande.
Sí. Entonces, lo que estamos hablando un poco es de qué realmente es la ecualización. Generalmente, estudiantes y creo que instructores también, actually instructors as well, because I think it was even a mistake that we may have done, de decir que en realidad la ecualización, la compensación está haciendo es balancear el oído medio con la presión externa, ¿no? Con la presión de afuera, pero no estamos realmente balanceando, sino que estamos restaurando el volumen del oído medio, pero no estamos balanceando la presión con el afuera. Es it would be actually a little bit harsh on the ears, pero sí, ¿no?
Sí.
Yeah, you're already introducing what I was about to say, but that's okay.
That's a good student, see?
Yeah, you're a good student. Yeah, already good student. Why? Because what happened when we go down? Okay, as we start our dive and as the external pressure increase, all our A spaces, all the A spaces that are inside our body decrease their volume because of the increasing of that side pressure. It's like you need to imagine our, can I make an example, practical example? Just wait a second.
You see, like, we like to talk about freediving, but as you open Giovanni's mouth about equalization, like, this can go deeper and deeper. He's like, no, well, we'll keep it over the top to start with. You can't really do that.
Lo que está diciendo un poco es eso, que todos los espacios de aire, creo que está diciendo eso, tienen cierto volumen a los cuales se puede llegar, pero la presión de afuera es distinta. This is so we all know he's in quarantine in Italy.
Yeah.
And he's been locked down for 2 months already.
Yeah, alone, completely alone. So this is our, actually it's not complete yet, but this is really important concept.
Yeah,
so that's why I want to share it with you. Okay. This is our ear. Okay. This is our ear, like this. Inside this pulse, there is air, and this air is at one bar. What happened that when we go down, when the pressure outside increase the volume of air that is inside this pod will become smaller, will decrease. But the pressure that is inside this pod will remain exactly the same like the outside pressure. So at 10 meters, for example, we have 2 bars of pressure. Inside our pod, we will have 2 bars of pressure, but the only difference is the volume of the air that is inside here will decrease. Decreasing the volume, the plastic film will just be sucked by the pods. Mm-hmm. So it's not the pressure that is pushing down, it's just the volume of the pod that's decreasing, sucking our eardrum inside. And this is huge difference.
Lo que está diciendo Jova, que es una diferencia muy grande, es que en la cacerola y con el film arriba, la diferencia es que no es que la presión adentro va a ser la misma que afuera, solo que a medida que cambie, el volumen del aire que está dentro se va a ir comprimiendo, lo que va a hacer que ese film empiece a tirar para adentro y las paredes de la cacerola empiecen a tirar para adentro. Pero la presión va a ser la misma que afuera. Lo que cambia es el volumen. Y eso es lo importante entender, que la ecualización lo que cambia es el volumen del aire dentro de nuestro oído y no la presión, ¿sí? Entonces, lo que nosotros estamos haciendo al ecualizar es como compensar ese volumen, ¿sí?
Mantener ese volumen,
como volver a mantener ese volumen, no igualar la presión. La presión sigue siendo la misma. Yeah.
And this is very important because when we go down, if we think that we need to restore the pressure, deeper we go, harder we want to push when we are equalizing. Instead of equalizing, it's quite the opposite. It's just about restoring the volume. It's just about moving air, putting air inside our middle ear. That's why it's very important to forget about pushing, because we are not fighting against the pressure.
Okay. One time I remember you saying, and it's just like it's equalizing is like cotton.
Yeah. I was waiting for you to say that.
I haven't written down, of course. Giovanni una vez se refirió a la ecualización como que la ecualización es como el algodón. ¿Por qué? Porque una vez que, realmente hay que ser muy suave cuando ecualizamos, en vez de tener la idea de que para empujar aire necesitamos empujar más y más, sino cada vez que vayamos más profundo vamos a pensar en que tenemos que empujar más porque hay más presión. Y eso no van de la mano. O sea, la ecualización tiene que ser suave, a soft, y suave y eficiente.
Coordination.
Sí, soft and efficient, basically.
Yeah, soft
and
efficient. Yeah, I like it. Yeah.
So, interesting to bring, I'm sorry, and this kind of goes back to what we were talking before about Valsalva and Frenzel. Sorry if I get distracted a little bit. Is like, we're talking about restoring the volume. And basically, like, a lot of people now, if they're not that familiar, will be thinking like, well, but if I use Valsalva or Frenzel, like, I'm restoring that volume. I think it's important to understand that there is a change of pressure in, like, if we are vertical up, because the air and the pressure is different, than if I'm facing down and I'm trying to go down, you know? So, to understand why, more than anything, it's not just the tension that is making Valsalva not be possible to happen, if not as well as you go deeper and that volume of air inside your body starts to compress, it's not only on your ears, and I think that that's why I'm bringing it right now.
Yeah.
It also happens on your lungs, yeah? So as you're going down, equalizing on free diving and your head first, and you're going down like that, and the volume of your lungs start to compress, then it becomes more difficult for you to try to push that air for your lungs up to your ears to restore, because the volume reduces, yeah? So this is one of the main reasons that brought me back to the first barrier we were talking about when you talked about volume, is one of the main reasons why Valsalva won't work once we are going head first. And a lot of you may say, yeah, but when I'm feet first and I pull from the line, I can equalize. And I've seen people do that until 35 meters and they have no problem. Yeah, because the same air and the same change of pressure helps that volume move up to your ears. And you're probably, if you're doing 30 meters, you're combining
it. Yeah, Frenzel, of course. They are combining, yeah,
and Valsalva. But when it happens on the first 5 to 10 meters, it's normally that will like reduce your possibility of equalizing comfortably head first with Valsalva, is that the volume of your lungs is not enough. So all that way you can't.
See, sorry, all of these that we are talking related to pressure, and I'm going to make Rose very happy right now, but not that much, is related to Boyle's Law. See, so if you have time, just go and Google Boyle's Law.
Yeah.
If not, we can use like another half an hour.
Pressure per volume equals cost.
Exactly. Okay. The more pressure you have, guys, the less volume we'll have, it's equal to Boyle's Law. So this is where all equalization comes from.
I just thought it was important, like as we got into volume, I thought it was a good point to make people understand that difference. And did you want to say that in Spanish? Lo que le estaba trayendo es, estamos hablando de la diferencia de presión y de volumen, ¿no? Entonces estamos hablando que para poder ecualizar nuestros oídos estamos restaurando el volumen y no la presión, la presión sigue siendo la misma. Lo que me hizo acordar es que estábamos hablando de las primeras barreras que hay y por qué el Valsalva no funciona. Muchas personas que hacen apnea y pueden bajar con los pies para abajo, empujando de la cuerda y van haciendo Valsalva, pero cuando se dan vuelta y tratan de ir cabeza abajo ecualizando y hacen Valsalva, no pueden. Y se debe a la misma razón. El volumen de aire que tenemos en los pulmones se va a comprimir, lo cual va a hacer que sea más difícil poder mover ese aire en contra de la presión que tenemos más profundo y tratar de que llegue a nuestros oídos. Entonces va a llegar una profundidad que ya no vamos a poder compensar con Valsalva. Mientras que con Frenzel, al ser un movimiento tan chico y tan cercano, en todo momento podemos seguir subiendo volumen y compensando nuestros oídos, ¿sí? Entonces es importante entender que la barrera del Valsalva con los pies para abajo es normal que funcione, pero con cabeza abajo no. Y es por eso que Valsalva en scuba sí funciona, ¿sí? Y esa es la gran diferencia. ¿Por qué en scuba no tengo ningún problema, pero en apnea, de repente, después de años de hacer scuba, sí me presento esta barrera? Es por esa misma razón. Porque con el tiempo y relajación, incluso haciendo Valsalva, en scuba puedo compensar. I was just saying that...
I just want to say that the also another difference of scuba compared to free diving, that we all have a breath. Inside scuba, they always have full lungs.
Exactly.
So they always have that. They can push. They always have
air to push. Exactly. And what I was bringing is, for the ones in English, is that in scuba, Valsalva still works for the same reason, because the volume of our lungs are always the same. And that's why sometimes we dove for a long period of time and then we try to pass to free diving and suddenly doesn't work, and you're like, but I've been scuba diving all my life, like why doesn't it work? And it's because of this, because you're probably doing Valsalva and your lungs are always on the same size, so you can equalize. For the ones that are having problem equalizing on scuba, I will suggest, of course, looking into Frenzel, because that's going to make it more gentle and more comfortable, but as well looking for relaxation, because with relaxation and a proper Valsalva technique, you will be able to equalize as well. Just because I know there is people here looking at, yeah, at that as well.
So then so yeah, turn well up, that you can just vertically.
Yeah, and being vertical, yeah, it's going to help air go up, up to your ears.
Mm-hmm. Because what we want to bring with this, I think, is mainly that, bueno, clearly we all know what we're talking about. So please do not give up when you're going to be trying to learn equalization. See, if you're not doing it, there is a, or if you're doing Valsalva, basically, there is a thousand ways that we can help you to do that. And I think maybe, Jova, you want to jump to the next step as well now to tell the rest of what's
okay. So
we have the difference and the Valsalva now.
Yeah, this is the main difference. Then what happened? That there are a lot of another zone of problem that happened in the equalization that is usually between 15, let's say, and 30, 32 meters, 35 meters. And that has an issue. It's a problem. because that kind of issue is because we said that Prenzel works till we are able to take air inside our mouth. When we do Prenzel, we had to think Prenzel in two steps. That one step is taking air from lungs and put in the mouth. And then there is a second step from mouth to ear. When you get problem in this zone between 15 and 30, 35, is because this step, this coordination between step one, lungs to mouth, and mouth to ear is not working anymore. And it is also a technical problem.
Entonces, lo que está diciendo es que el próximo bloqueo puede llegar dentro, ok, ecualizamos, sí, bajamos de repente a 15 metros, entre 15 y 30 metros, va a haber otra barrera. La ecualización nunca se termina de trabajar, en ningún momento de la apnea, so welcome to freediving. Después entre 15 a 20 metros sí va a haber otra barrera, que puede ser la descoordinación de movimientos a esa profundidad, por lo que va a afectar de alguna forma en la parte técnica de lo que estamos haciendo en esa profundidad. You can continue.
So we just need to become more aware on how to do these two kinds of steps. The third limit of the equalization is after you pass the 35 meters, 30, 35 meters, because it happened really, really strange, not strange things, it's related about the lungs volume. We need to think the equalization like a car, let's say, where your ear is the engine of your car, your mouth is the gasoline tank of your car, and your lungs is the gasoline station. While you're going down, it happens a certain depth where there is no more gasoline station, and after that you finish the engine that you have inside your mouth, that's it. That usually is called residual volume while freediving.
Okay, y lo próximo que puede pasar es ya una vez que estamos a unos 35 metros, que esto ya es obviamente apnea en profundidad, no tan profundo, pero en profundidad still, porque ya estamos llegando a lo que llamamos el volumen residual, ¿sí? En donde no vamos a poder sacar más aire de nuestros pulmones y lo que la comparación que está haciendo es que el oído medio sería como el motor del auto, la boca sería el tanque de gas y los pulmones la gasolinera. Entonces, a medida que vamos más profundo y dejamos las gasolineras más y más atrás porque el pulmón se hace más chico, ya no vamos a tener gasolineras y vamos a tener que usar solo el aire que nos queda en el tanque, básicamente. Entonces, hay que tener awareness y coordinación en solo usar en este momento el aire en la boca y no de los pulmones porque ya está suficientemente chicos y no podríamos estar usando ese mismo aire.
Yeah, so, what we can do to go deep, because there are many divers that can dive like 100 meters even below, so that is possible because those kind of free divers, because that kind of free divers are able to fill up the gasoline tank. It's like if you had to do a long trip, you go to the gasoline station, you charge completely your ear, your gasoline tank, and then you do your trip. This kind of equalization technique is called mouthfeel. It's what you used to call mouthfeel.
But one thing before jumping into mouthfeel, which for me would be already the third stage, is because we're talking about residual volume now, but I think there is a lot of people stuck in the between 15 to 30s. That what can be, I kind of believe that it's, as you said, a lot of coordination, but as well a lot of relaxation on those steps.
Do you want to go into questions? I mean, do you want to go now into questions or?
I think that there is a bridge on the middle, like that we didn't really go into that much of running out of air. What we meant, we just mentioned, it was that of we run out of air within the in our mouth to equalize frenzel during those first 15 to 25 meters. Like basically, people can experience problems equalizing around there. It's very common.
I will
explain why that happens. Maybe just giving a general.
I will explain that better. Look, the problem is that for all people, I'm talking now for all people that can do frenzel. Okay, so let's say Valsalva has problems. So we're just talking about frenzel now.
Yeah.
Once one guy is performing frenzel, one of the others is performing frenzel, he knows already how, let's say, keep the glottis closed and pump the air up. But we said that frenzel is a kind of equalization technique that works if you have air inside your mouth, okay? And usually in frenzel, this is also an instinctive movement. For all the people who are following us, I will invite you to do this as an exercise. It's very easy. You just need to pinch your nose and equalize, but instead of keeping your nose full pinch, just leave your nostril a little bit open. So between one equalization and the other one, air can go out from your nostril. Yeah, Lucre was doing it. I'm showing you again. So I just do frenzel. I don't pinch tight, completely tight my nose, and just let air go from my nose.
Entonces lo que está haciendo Ayoba es básicamente invitando a los que tienen estos problemas entre 15 a 30 metros de ecualización a hacer este ejercicio para darse cuenta un poco lo que está pasando, que es pinzarse la nariz, dejando salir un poco más de aire, y en lo que ecualizan, vayan observando qué pasa, entonces, y viendo.
Okay,
y,
now. Yeah. Okay, can you do it again? Can you do it again so I will explain what's happening? Sí. If you try this exercise, you felt that all the time air is going out from your nose. That air, you see, she's equalizing. Her throat is going up. When her throat is going up, the air is going out from her nose and the mouth becomes empty. But when she do the next equalization, the following equalization, she has new air inside the mouth. That is because she is doing those two steps. She's taking air from the lungs, putting into the mouth, and from the mouth, pushing it up. And this is happening just like an automatism. If you try, then you could do it that. Now you are able to feel that there is this kind of a translation.
Entonces, lo que empieza a pasar acá es que a la hora de hacerlo, estamos haciendo los dos pasos. Estamos abriendo la glotis, pasando el aire a la boca, y luego de la boca al oído medio. No estamos tratando de hacer todo junto a la vez. Pero esto viene como un movimiento natural. Something to observe in this exercise is the tension in the core, ¿sí? Vayan fijándose a medida que hacen este ejercicio, cuánto esfuerzo a medida que siguen están haciendo en todo el área abdominal, ¿sí? Porque muchas veces también eso es simplemente lo que pasa en profundidad, que empezamos a tensar, y no tenemos aire y en realidad es solo que tenemos tensión. See, so there is what I was saying, that sometimes when we are doing this exercise, guys, you might start feeling when you're starting to run out of air or you're on a breath hold, that you're going to start tensing your core. So just observe that as well. because that might be what it's being replicated or reflected in the water as well. So this exercise actually helps a lot to observe a little bit of that too, about the tension, etc.
And I mean, I just want to show you this exercise to make you feel how much these two steps, like translation and compression, it's an automatism and it's easy to do it. The problem is that we are underwater and we are diving and the pressure is increasing. The volume of our lungs decrease. And this step, this automatism, if it's not very clear, if you're not aware of that, is when you get the problem and that's why you get stuck. Because it's not working anymore, so you can't take air anymore inside your mouth and you got get stuck. That's it.
Cool.
Nice.
You want to explain this?
Awesome.
I think I explained it kind of.
Okay. So now I think that is it more clear now why we get stuck?
Yeah, totally.
In those two. Okay. And even now, even in this kind of situation, to go over, you just need to become more aware about these two steps, translation and equalization. Before reaching, can we go to the next step as well?
Yeah.
See, one question for you to answer to everyone. Can we reach residual volume at 20 meters? ¿Podemos llegar a nuestro volumen residual a unos 20 metros? Because that happens a lot. People are like, oh, I'm getting to my residual volume. And it's like, no.
There is a difference between, sometimes we can just if you are not aware about that steps and we do some technical stuff wrong, like if we put some kind of tension on our throat, if we put our tongues in some particular position, such as our head in our particular position, we just limitate ourselves. We just like block completely ourselves and we block this movement that allowed us to take air inside of our mouth. By the way, this movement, for who already heard about this, is called reverse packing. Is what do you call reverse packing? We call reverse packing.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So yes, guys, I usually we are not reaching residual volume at those steps.
Yeah, we are not. Yeah. Yeah.
It's only the neck, relaxation, etc.
Lo que Cande preguntaba es si a los 20 metros podemos estar llegando a nuestro volumen residual. Y yo decía que realmente no, que generalmente por una mala combinación de técnicas y por no saber llenar de aire correctamente la boca cuando estamos haciendo Frenzel, generalmente podemos tener esa sensación de que me quedé sin aire y que estoy a mi máximo, pero generalmente viene de no saber recargar. Cuando nosotros bajamos la lengua y cargamos, que es lo que le llamamos reverse packing, que es carpa en español, carpa inversa, ¿no?
Perdón, no me sé el término. En italiano es carpa inversa.
No, es carpa inversa en italiano.
La capo molta, la carpa inversa.
No sabemos llenar de aire la boca, por lo cual podemos llegar a sentir que estamos en volúmenes residuales cuando en realidad no estamos llegando a ese límite.
Yeah, exactly. So, which is the problem? That even for all the people that this coordination between step one and step two works, they will get to a point where they reach the residual volume, so neither with reverse packing is able to take air out anymore. So we reach the third limit. To go over that limit, we need just to learn before arriving to residual volume, so where at that kind of depth that we are still able to take out air from our lungs, we need to stow air inside our mouth and manage that air. That is called mouthfeel. Mm-hmm. And is an advanced, let's say, equalization technique.
Which we can go, we had a question even from Amerigo, hola Amerigo, before of a little bit of deep tips that we could give
me to
practice.
Yeah. Actually, Amerigo was asking, I will put it up here.
How not to swallow the mouthfeel, a tip not to swallow the mouthfeel, basically. I think this is very interesting for people that are already going to that.
Yeah, I need a bit of translation for this question.
He's asking what to do, like if we have any tip for him not to swallow his mouth. Mm-hmm. Like, okay. That is a very common mistake at this stage, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. It depends the depths and everything, but he's managing deep dives, no? So we know where he's.
Okay. Usually, when we go into this equalization technique, that is the mouthfeel, first we need to learn how to do a proper charge. So how to store properly air inside our mouth. Mm-hmm. Second, we need to don't isolate the air that we brought inside our mouth, because there is some can happen something, you know, before I did the example with the car and the gasoline, some people have the feeling like having air inside the mouth, adding a lot of air inside the mouth, but they are not able to using it. And it's like, if you go to a gasoline station, you fill up your tank, but you don't put the gasoline inside your, I mean, inside the tank, but you just put it.
It's not running through the hose. Mm-hmm. Bueno, lo que está diciendo ahí Jova es un poco que hay dos partes en esto del mouthfeel, que es uno, pasar el aire propiamente a la boca y luego asegurarse de no estar isolating, ¿cómo se dice en español? De no estar, helpful Spanish, isolating, no,
aislando.
Aislar, eso, no aislar el aire que está en la boca. Muchas veces podemos pensar que tenemos todo el aire que tenemos en la boca, que lo tenemos, pero no está yendo a ningún lado ni está haciendo el uso muy eficiente de aire. Que en el caso del ejemplo del auto antes, es como aislar por el puro motor del tanque. Si bien el tanque está yendo, no llega gasolina al motor.
Okay.
I like that example.
Or to lose the air. So we just brought air inside our mouth, but we are not able to keep our glottis closed. So we just open the glottis and all the air that is inside the mouth just go back inside our lungs. And that's it. We are not able to take it anymore.
Y el tercero es obviamente la apertura de la glotis, ¿no? O sea, tenemos que estar controlando la glotis desde el principio, pero el abrir la glotis va a hacer que el aire directamente se pierda.
Yeah, se pierda. So these are like the three main issues about mouthfeel, and they depend on technical stuff, of course. For example, first thing about the charge, it's really, really important to don't fill up. So we go also little tip, to don't fill up your mouth and stow air inside the cheeks like a squirrel. This is very bad, for example, for the charge.
Muchas veces hacemos carga, chicos, y lo que hacemos es directamente parecer como pequeñas ardillas o chipmunks, se llaman o algo así. Que hacemos que los cachetes parezcan bien compresionados. Yeah, ¿sí? Entonces ahí, si ustedes observan que en el mouse le están haciendo la carga y están haciendo esto, ya quiere decir que el aire está acumulado de una forma distinta o hay algún error en el charge, mm-hmm. en la carga.
This time it's much better if you keep your cheeks soft and your mouth well open, like to fill up your mouth vertical and not horizontal.
Mm-hmm. Entonces, lo que tenemos que asegurarnos es que la boca se abra vertical.
Yeah, that's so, it.
Entonces, si está así, ya sabemos que está todo bien locked and not locked.
And to learn how to use all the three structures that you have on your mouth to press air, like to learn how to use the cheeks, learn how to use the jaw, and learn how to use the tongue.
I think that for the advanced people that are already mouthfeel, Joa did last week live on Mouthfeel on Demand. I highly recommend you to go and look at it because it's opening a whole topic. So I would highly recommend you to go into the moving.
I will give you the link.
You can put the link on the comments and go into the video to see what he's explaining about it, because there you will find more in detail tips and things for the mouthfeel itself. Because I know now we're doing general, we've been speaking a lot of things, but maybe we're not going deeper enough for a person that is trying to look for an answer for that.
Chicos,
la importancia que está trayendo ahora Jova, si bien obviamente vamos a estar trayendo muchísimos más workshops de ecualización, estamos tratando de cubrir una vida entera en 1 hora y 10 y probablemente se nos extienda un poco más, pero estamos como coliflores yendo de tema a tema para que puedan tener una idea de qué hacer y cómo, y si están más interesados en buscar más a fondo, ahí Jova va a compartir, Giovanni va a compartir el link, bueno, lo
ahí ya lo compartí,
de la carga on demand, pero lo que pero para mí lo más importante que trajo Jova recién en inglés era que la práctica de los diferentes movimientos por separado. Muy normal, es muy, muy normal que al principio la gente trate de hacer mouthfeel y empiece con la pura carga y ya a compresionar, que no va realmente a poder reconocer lo que se está haciendo. Entonces, ¿cómo era? ¿Isolate, Lu?
Aislar.
Aíslen cada ejercicio, ¿sí? Aíslen los cachetes, aíslen el movimiento de la lengua y aíslen el movimiento de la mandíbula. Entonces, primero poder hacerlos por separado perfecto para poder después combinarlos, y ya a partir de que cada uno vaya encontrando su forma de ecualizar más cómoda, una vez que eso ya está controlado, entonces poder aplicarlo en el agua, ¿no? I think we didn't say it in English. So, as you were saying, Jova, is the importance of isolating every single movement, master the movements. Saludita, sí, I'm going to open a beer soon. And then basically seeing which technique is going to be more comfortable for one, but once all of the movements are already managed and controlled. And from there, that's the link of mouthfeel in demand. And of course, on moving limits and with Giovanni, you can just look for deep equalization of everything. Go on the webpage later.
We're going to show you now really quick a little bit the platform, like so that you can find out a little bit more, because there is so much information on equalization and there's so many different levels and from
in training that you can do.
We'll show that and then we'll get into questions, because I know that people, we promised you that you were going to get. And actually, if you're waiting until the end, because you can win online course. Yeah, so I know that a lot of you are just waiting here, because you can win today a self-paced course online, which is a lot of tools. But you will have to answer questions about what we have covered right now. So we will show you that and go into, like, two of you were asking about proper position of your head and technical tips. That is basically, we go to streamlining again, like being on a streamlined position, having your head nice and straight for any of the exercise of equalization, starting from beginners to advanced. Our body and our streamline is the main and key thing to then be able to work on any technique itself, because we want to have everything comfortable for air to flow. Yeah, so nice and relaxed, head straight. I don't understand the camera. Yeah, no tension. Yeah, the shoulders relaxed and your head on a straight and comfortable position. It's like if they will be pulling you from a string from the
top.
Of
course, time in the water, it's gonna bring all of that awareness. If you did one course of 2 days or 3 days in that case, I'm sorry, it's just personal effort too. But if you just started freediving, give your time starts in the water, of course.
Yeah, that's key.
What else? No, I think we can jump to the next topic. Otherwise, we can just speak about all of this for 2 or 3 hours. Like,
Yeah. I told you that I'm a very boring guy that I can just talk about this. So we just talk about the, let's say, three common barriers of equalization that equalization just puts in front of us while we go free diving. But the good news is that equalization, it's most of the time about technique, and has every kind of technique can be learned. How do you learn technique? Just with the right instruments, with the proper motivation, and with tools. Equalization is a kind, to learn the equalization, we really believe that you need to train, because you need to build the kind of automatism. Because when you go diving, you need we are not really, our mind is not always clear underwater. So what happened that we train a lot on dry, we can create automatism on our body and our glottis and our tongue and our soft palate with all the structures that are involved in equalization. And once we have that kind of automatism and we go diving, it's much more easy to apply those skills, those equalization skills. And for this reason, we develop an online platform that helps people, first of all, to reach everybody because it's online. So we don't need to meet, let's say, for training the equalization. And another very important thing that once you are on dry, you can train whenever you like, because what you need is just like your mobile or your laptop and one auto vent. Even with the pink balloon, it's okay. So I want just to show you a little bit how our courses are done. For example, I'm going to show you this part of our online academy.
Mm-hmm. One, chicos, for example. ¿Esto es el software que los chicos usan para enseñar?
No. Sí. Sorry. Es que le iba a traducir justo lo que decía Jova antes, era, bueno, que obviamente la ecualización lleva a práctica. Hay muchos como pasos para llegar a esta técnica y para ecualización que se tienen que practicar y practicar y practicar hasta poder automatizarlos y de a poco ir combinándolos. Entonces, lo que ellos han hecho... Ellos han creado una plataforma online, por un lado, para poder llegarle a todo el mundo y, por otro lado, porque realmente son cosas, trabajos que uno tiene que hacer en casa y no necesariamente tienen que estar todos los días, estar en el agua o que va a pasar de un momento al otro. Entonces, como necesitan práctica, ellos han desarrollado toda esta plataforma online para poder enseñar ecualización desde casa. Ya, yo.
Ya. So, for example, this is our online academy. This is the part of academy that we prepare for our Amankai team, because as we said before, Amankai, they are attending for the instructor course about equalization. So we're really happy to have them inside our team. And for example, in this area of the platform, I just uploaded two courses. One is START, that, for example, is the course that allow you to solve the first equalization, let's say, barrier, like the friends that like it's the course where you can learn how to perform friends. Mm-hmm. This is how our courses are done. They are kind of we always start from theory, from the beginning of the equalization. Okay, we have a protocol. We tested this protocol for many, many, many years. Believe me, if I say many years. And this is kind of the training material, how it's done. We can leave also in the chat the credential for the academy. Yeah, you see about equalization, what we were talking about, equalization, mm-hmm. and Boyle's law, everything is explained. You have like...
That's Federico. Federico.
Our star.
The Italian with the strongest accent in English. It's so funny.
But can you hear it? Can you
input
the audio?
No.
Okay. Because I just have my AirPods. You see, we have a test. We can just check if you are understood and stuff like that. This is just, for example, a theoretical part. Then we have all the part that regards the exercises. So which are the exercises that you need to develop on dry to, for example, to learn, to learn how to Frenzel. This one is about the skills that allow you to learn how to use your mouth as a pump to push air, for example. There is the tutorial. All the exercises follow this kind of protocols. They have an objective, the tools, the training tools that you need to use for perform that exercise. Our Federico, our model,
Lo que está mostrando ahí Jova es un poco, entonces, es el software que usamos o que usan y que vamos a usar nosotros también para enseñar. Con toda la parte teórica, con todos los videos que hay que hacer, con todo el seguimiento para poder, ya sea o aprender Frenzel o aprender mouse, ¿no?
And
deep diving. Or hands-free as well. Sí, because
todos los cursos vienen acompañando con una parte teórica, con una parte práctica, con los ejercicios, como veían los videos de Federico, con cada ejercicio, con qué van a necesitar para poder ir yendo paso a paso a manejar la barrera y a superar la barrera que estemos buscando, ¿no?
Yeah. And for example, this was just like a self-paced study, but there is also the possibility to take part to live course where you just go and integrate those exercises that you do just in self-paced, having classes directly with us, with qualified instructor.
Just to clarify, basically they have two ways, two main ways of giving courses. One is you take the material and you give it at your own rhythm and at your own pace, where you get all the exercises you just saw with all the explanations and you do it at home. Or you get the materials, but you combine it with workshops online with an instructor. In this case, with Jova or with Fede, and also in a very near future with us.
Claro.
In a very near future with us. With Cande, we're actually working with all these materials for Spanish. So hopefully soon we will have all the materials in Spanish as well. Lo que estábamos diciendo es, los chicos tienen, los cursos se dividen básicamente en dos. Y lo que es uno, para que ustedes aprendan por su propia cuenta, pueden comprar el material. Y como vieron con todas las explicaciones y todo, pueden hacer sus cursos. O por otro lado, pueden, por ejemplo, hacer el curso online más el tutorial con instructor online. Entonces, van a combinar los materiales con las correcciones y las clases live con instructor. En este caso, o Jova o Fede, y en un muy cercano futuro, esperemos, Cande o yo. Con Cande estamos trabajando en los materiales en español para Moving Limits, cosa de poder traerlo todo en español también.
We need to convince them to pass our exams, no matter what. So, people, let's do it. This is peer pressure now. No, y, sí.
Luque, I just sent you on the chat, like a link to go, and I want to say like the demonstration of our courses so they can see how the exercises are done.
Okay.
So you can share with all of them.
Okay, I'll keep those ones and then I'll share them.
Okay, this
that they've invented, that they came up with, it is very useful to, let's say you're on holidays. Many people have only 2 days in Mexico or 2 days on holidays and it's not enough time to learn equalization. Many times we make it, pero people that have learned to equalize with us, you've seen us, we are little sergeants for 48 hours making you trying to learn, and the idea is that you can take the time to learn each step. So if you already know through your head that you are having troubles with equalizing, contact us. And this is a perfect time actually for everyone that is at home to learn equalization. Yeah. So by the time that you are here, you already don't have to struggle with that part, as freediving is already challenging itself enough itself.
It does. Yeah,
lo que les decía un poco, chicos, es en la Riviera, la verdad que nosotros tenemos mucho turismo y son 2 días de curso a 3 días de cursos. Y muchas veces tenemos que hacer milagros para que puedan ecualizar y muchas veces sí nos convertimos en pequeños sargentos teniéndolos haciendo ejercicios pobres que la gente me llora porque people cry to me because they are having like their nose is just really, really wounded already. La gente me llora porque tienen la nariz ya con el otovent, nada, rota casi. Entonces, sí, sí pueden, si ya saben que tienen los problemas con la ecualización desde antemano y todo, tomen estos cursos antes, para una vez que vienen 2 días al agua, pueden realmente enfocarse en lo que el primer nivel les da, porque si no, muchas veces es el primer día de pura ecualización. So, yeah, contact us.
I think that is going to be like a challenge now.
Yeah.
Or later. No,
we can.
What do you want to do?
We can release the questions.
We can release the questions. We're going to put up, guys, 3 questions now. And this is going to be, you are going to win a self-paced course with Moving Limit. Depending on your level, it may be a start one or a deep one, depending on where you're standing and what you need. So I'm going to put the questions and you have to answer them on the post. Yeah. The first one to answer the 3 questions correct will win. We're not going to look at it immediately. Like we need to make sure that the streaming that we have is exactly the same that comes out on the Facebook. Yeah. So I'm going to release the questions right now so that you can start answering them and see who's the winner. And after that, if you want to start putting your comments and your questions for Giovanni, we can quickly jump and try to answer anything that came up to your mind on this time. Yeah. Kanda?
Yeah.
No, see, just that. Just make sure you first answer the questions. And then once we did it, you put the your own questions. So we make everything clear that the thing that we are giving, the price that we're giving, which is self-paced, which is a self-paced, it is, correct me if I'm wrong, it's just the material, no? It's not the
class. Okay. No, it's the course.
Lo que vamos a estar haciendo ahora es escribiendo las 3 preguntas para que las podemos escribir en español también, de hecho.
Sí. Entonces vas a tener que seguir hablando.
Vamos a ponerlas en español, en inglés. No, it's not a problem for me.
No, actually, because to have them both at the same time, para ponerlas las 2 al mismo tiempo, we're going to write them we're going to show them in English, and we're going to read them in Spanish.
Okay, dale.
Yeah, we're going to read because.
Entonces, vamos a traducirlas hablando al español. Vamos a decirles y van a tener que contestar las 3 preguntas. El primero que contesta las 3 preguntas bien y primero, si idealmente, se va a llevar este curso online que por ahora está en inglés, en italiano y en francés.
Yeah, already it's soon French and Spanish.
Okay, sí. Spanish yet.
And Greek as well.
And Greek. Oh. If we have any
great. A lot of people working on process.
Yeah, a lot of people is working on process.
Entonces, vamos a darle tiempo, vamos a escribir las preguntas y vamos a dar un rato, así el stream se pone acorde porque estamos con un poco de delay. ¿Vale? Así que, show us your magic.
Wait. Porque las estoy escribiendo en español y las voy a mostrar en el chat.
Y prometemos que cuando cumplamos 2 horas, we're done. We swear that once we are 2 hours fast, we're done. Pero. Y si quieren empezar luego de responder las preguntas, empezar a escribir respuestas. digo, empezar a escribir preguntas que tengan para nosotros, pues libres.
Yeah, I just started to have a look to the questions.
Sí, so. Tenemos preguntas desde antes, de hecho. We can start with the ones I want to look. Oh.
The questions are going out right now. I'm putting them in English and in Spanish on the chat. Las voy a poner en español en el chat, aunque se las leamos para que las puedan leer, ¿sí? Entonces, en inglés, Cande, las puedes empezar a leer. There you go, people.
First question. Why Valsalva works better feet first than head first?
Why Valsalva? En español, Cande. En español, por favor.
La primera, ¿por qué la técnica de Valsalva funciona mejor haciendo pies primero que cabeza primero? La segunda, ¿por qué no podemos ecualizar si bien tenemos aire en la boca? Y la tercera, ¿cuál es la diferencia principal entre el Valsalva y el Frenzel?
Okay, you guys can go answering on the comments. I'm gonna try to see if I can see it on Facebook.
Of course, it's gonna win the first who replies right all the three questions.
To answer the question, right. Claro. To answer the question, write the three of them together. So, Rosie, I just read that it was gravity, but write the three together so we can know that you set the three properly.
The three of them, right.
We're not very good at this thing of...
It's a try, like, yeah, it's kind of complicated here.
And it's coincidence if Lucre or me win the prize. No.
Can I answer? No.
We had Mariana, but I think she's not here, but Mariana was like, can I win the prize? I'm like, yeah.
Yes, of course you can.
But she's not here, so no. Mm-hmm.
Okay,
people, TikTok. Now, meanwhile, we can read questions from before, Lu. And we had some questions on Instagram. You wanna put up
a tiempo. If you want to go reading them. Sí, Anto, ¿puedes jugar?
Ah, Anto, obvio. Anto, it's our angel behind all of this, so everyone knows.
Todos pueden jugar. Everyone can play. Everyone can play.
But if you're our student, you better answer properly.
Gravity? Yeah. Judar? What does it mean, Judar? Help?
Jugar. Jugar is play. No.
Jogar.
Jocare. Ah, Jocare.
Jocare. Okay. No, but Ama, you're looking all the videos. Think last you can't play. I'm joking.
I'm gonna lie. I'm gonna start.
Remember, you need to answer the three of them correct.
Yeah, I think that we have a win. Yeah, we have a winner actually.
We have a winner, no? Spanish, no?
I think we have a winner. Okay.
Very good though for the rest. Ruhei, Joe, I love that team.
What?
No, there is Ruhe and Joel, just two students.
The pressure difference in that, too, because you are not relaxed. Frenzel, Uguali, Equalize, with air in lungs, pushing direction. Salva, Uguali, Equalize, with air in mouth. Mm. Ruhe, good attempt, but... Mm.
Okay, so... The winner is.
Dun 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 dun. Who's the winner?
Who's the winner?
Joa. Bueno, ya tenemos. It's actually everyone answered in English, so I think that we can.
No, the winner. Ah, sí.
No, the winner, no, but she answered in English. She's in Mexico, but she answered in English.
The winner is? No, declare it.
I think so.
You are the one giving it away. You're the one giving it away. Yeah. You have to say, declare. I'm not taking responsibility.
Yeah.
Very nice. Very, very nice.
Very fast. Very fast, and her answers.
Yeah,
were
but
very
I saw more her than anyone else during these weeks. I saw her every webinar.
She's in every webinar. She was looking, how can I get this course? Like, how can
good, Amma. Good job.
Claro,
congratulations.
Good player.
Hard work always pay. Hard work always pay.
Hard work pays off.
Always pay. Yeah.
Very good, Amma. Qué bueno.
Awesome, guys. Bien, Amma. Aiden, you're already in contact with Joa, so you can...
It's really funny because she just applied for a hands-free course as well.
Guys,
thank you, Ruhe. You were
very, very close. So if anyone has questions for Giovanni, now's your time. If not, we will let you all go and be
happy.
Free and happy.
You're having fun with us, though. We know that. we can start reading the questions that we already have. And then
we have a few questions that came from Instagram today. And it was, well, how to practice equalization in shallow water and land? And what alignment massage points are good to release near jaw neck tension? So let's answer the first part. I think that the second part, there is no technical answer on us. On us, like there is, I think that just,
all the neck area.
For me, as having some training on massage, like there is all points on this part of your neck and behind your ears that work on that. Just the little bones up here on the back of your head are really good points, but just there's no technical answer. It's not there's no on and on button, on and off button to release the tensions and that's it.
Yeah.
Practice equalization in shallow or land. I think that Joa can answer that.
Sorry, very quickly. To that answer is, that tension that you're talking about is not necessarily applied in the equalization field. Of course, it is for the relaxation. So basically work on relaxation, on stretching, on different things to be able to relax like that. See, Giuseppe, you can continue.
Okay, how to practice equalization in shallow water land? It depends on what you mean by shallow water, because it depends according to the depth that you have. You can do different kind of
exercises. I think they're talking of a pool at home or outside the water.
Okay, a pool. I think that the best way, if you have a pool, you can train on differences between air translation and compression phase, for example. So it can be a very good, useful exercise to just lay down like in butt position. You know, butt position is when you just put your legs on the board of the pool and you go down with your back. So with your back on the board. Yeah, that's it.
Of course, yeah.
You can try to do a charge, okay, like a big mouthful, for example. But I don't know which kind of technique he wants to learn. For example, if we talk about...
I know she's a beginner. Sorry, I know she for a fact she's a beginner. So maybe,
okay,
bending and with empty lungs. Mm-hmm. No?
Okay, yeah. So if she's a beginner, she can just train in trying that exercise that we did before, pinching a little bit the mask and just equalizing, letting all the time a little bit of air to go out from her mask. So just head down, pinch a little bit their nose. She can train with the mask or even with the nose clip is enough, just not fully tight, or even without just pinching her nose. And equalizing. And paying attention between one equalization and the other one to keep the belly relaxed.
Entonces, lo que está preguntando Vivi muy rápido es cómo equalizar, probablemente...
The alignment is not, I mean, for me, my opinion is that you need to imagine to have the line in front of you and just to align the chin and the nose to the line. So it's not here, It's just this alignment. So just it's mm-hmm. like if you have the line in front of you and to align your chin and your nose to the line. That's it.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. Yeah. Candice, you were saying.
No, que estaba, es que no sé si hay mucha gente ya hablando español.
I think that everyone speaks English right sí. now. Ruja is asking, do you teach how to do hands-free?
Yes, of course, I do.
Ruge is a person that took about 6 trips to Playa del Carmen to learn how to equalize.
It took what? How long?
6 trips or 5 trips.
Oh, wow.
A lot from New York. Between Fede and Cande, we could make him work it out with a lot of patience, Ruge. Pero he's the vivid example.
From his part.
He's the vivid example. 100%. He's the vivid example of how actually practice eventually, no matter what. This is for everyone now watching. It's going to make you equalize eventually.
We have a guy that from Amankai that learned how to do hands-free with an online course with me, and I never saw him. I never met him.
Ken Simon?
Mm-hmm. And they learned. Chris.
Ah, sí.
Of course, Chris.
Our cowboy, Chris. Yeah.
Cowboy Chris.
Yeah.
Where are you? We love you, Cowboy Chris, as well.
Yeah, we do. Okay, cool. Then,
so Ruge, okay. The answer is yes.
And then we have
Suzanne. One experience.
Yeah, when experiencing equalization problems, why does it hurt most around 10 meters? We've covered that with all the Valsalva. This is something that came up.
More or less, though, because we didn't mention so much boil, but Susan, the biggest change of pressure in the water is from the surface
to 10 meters.
So that's why probably you're going to feel the biggest pain past up to that depth.
Yeah.
And is the kind of zone that if you don't do Frenzel, it's really, really hard to equalize because of the technique.
Exactly. Here.
Yeah. And it's not like making this is deal, I guess.
Gabriel, my friend's technique is slow, like making it difficult to swallow. How can I complete it faster? Because maybe it's not frontal, but it's just swallowing. Swallowing, it's a kind of.
This is Geoff, actually.
See, this is Geoff, which Geoff, one student, I believe. Could be as well tension, no? Like when you're trying that you just put tension in here instead of movement, no?
Yeah, it depends. I don't know. But if you're talking like a difficult swallow, maybe it's just not a good pushing. Technique. I mean, it's not a proper frenzel technique. You just need to work a little bit on your frenzel technique and maybe you can just get over this difficulty.
That I think it brings us back to the first question he did before, that we answered before, about not being able to go further than 20. I think that with working a little bit the full frenzel technique, it will bring this out and actually make sure
of course,
that...
Of course, it's a combination of those two. It can be a combination of frenzel on the beginning, and of course, if the frenzel is not working, either the automatism between a translation and compression is not working well, and on that zone, like the 20 meters, if it goes up with the tongue and it kind of swallow, it can't take any more from the lungs, and that's why it stops. So just working on frenzel and how to do step one and step two, it will easily go over the 20 meters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Awesome. Do we have any other questions?
Thank you for everyone to staying for 2 hours with us.
Yeah, this took like when we started, 1 hour maximum, 1 hour 15. And it's been way long. I think what we will be doing, guys, is the idea is to get more specific topics as we go. We wanted to introduce you and for you to meet Giovanni and as well to cover a little bit of a general aspect and see what you guys are looking for. And the idea is to start covering, either doing workshops to work on a specific things, but as well to cover specific topics more detailed and more into every subject. We know this was very general, but I think it was a great introduction to understanding the general equalization, what equalization is all about. Yeah. So do we have anyone else, any other questions? We're good. Okay. So I think we're going to say goodbye to everyone online. Kande?
See, wait. Sorry, I had my brain froze.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for everyone. I hope you enjoyed it as we did, because it's actually something that we can just talk and talk and talk. hopefully you are joining us in the following
on Monday. On Monday, we will be introducing Max, our instructor and marine biologist as well. Wow. So he will be covering... He is from California, and he will be covering really interesting topics. So we're excited about changing a little bit from the technical part to the environmental part.
And he loves freediving so much. And he speaks like Californian, so it's really fun.
So we invite you to meet Max and talk about a little bit of fisheries, marine biology, and a lot more that we will be publishing you on the next couple of days. Thank you very much for everyone that is with us.
Thank you, everybody.
See you on Monday. Bye.
Thank you, Lucre. Thank you, Kande.
You're welcome. Thanks to you.